Good evening. My name is Liz Solomon, and I'd like to welcome you to the Westchester East Theater Company's production of the Brothers Grimm Spectacularthon. Before we begin the show, we ask that all cell phones and electronic devices be turned off. It's distracting and disrespectful to the actors on stage when you intentionally use your electronic devices. There will be a 10-minute intermission following Act 1. During this time, you may purchase candy and drinks at the concession stand in the auditorium lobby, or send a candy gram to your favorite actor on stage. Please place all trash in the trash cans in the lobby. Do not bring food or drink into the auditorium lobby. Actors will meet you following the performance outside. On behalf of the East Theater Company, I thank you for coming tonight. Enjoy the show.
Ever seen.
Hey, I thought we were supposed to be catering back here.
There's like a
anything somewhere?
Where?
I don't know, in the back somewhere?
Is there anything to drink?
No.
These actors are so insanely talented that they are.
I see it!
Do you see the radiator?
No. Oh, wait! No.
All this cause went on it, new ball. That's like 3 stories per minute.
Or a different number if you actually know math. And we are going to keep the original endings intact.
Violence. People being cut open with scissors.
Yeah. And we are going to perform them as originally intended, which is
that it's all one enormous mega super story that will rock your world.
Still into all that weird stuff. You just didn't have it. Anyway, I'll make you rich. My not rich enough for your jet fighter, but rich enough, and I only ask for one thing in return.
Okay, deal. Broke himself in half. Do it.
stupid little witch.
Enchantress.
Whatever, witch.
I will cast a spell on you.
Bring it on, let's see what you got.
Now's the time, Mom, let's run.
Quiet, honey, I'm watching this. Go, devil.
I just like him better.
I curse you.
I curse you right back. You know what? This is stupid. If you sign this one small contract, how would you keep the muscle?
Sounds like a plan.
And I disappear in a cloud of brimstone.
Well, come along, Uncle.
Where are we going?
I've built a great tower for you.
Run along, dear.
But Mom, I don't want to go with the evil enchantress.
Aw, that sucks, because I didn't want to raise a spoiled brat.
Sometimes you don't always get what you want, unless you make a deal with the devil and some other people. Bye.
So the enchanters took our little lady along to our high tower downstairs. As for the grown our prince.
Hey, I'm back. What I miss?
The force of the darkness got no back for an otter soul.
You want to know Hawaii?
Yeah.
I lived happily ever after. As for Rapunzel.
So, I just sit here in my tower, right?
Right.
Why?
Oh, no reason. Probably I'm just bored. Or I could be acting out for a bad childhood. Or the feminist interpretation would be that being a woman is a dead end field in our society, and locking you in this tower, which in itself is a phallic symbol, symbolizes that there is no escape from womanhood in the universe. All that matters about you is your hair, which in turn is a highway for the masculine force of our patriarchal society to enter in and take possession of you. Or, as a woman, a possession is all that you are.
Right.
I wrote a paper on this in college. Gotta be plus, because I was discriminated against. Anyway, you're going to wait here until I come up with something original to do with you. In the meantime, I want you to try all those radioactive hair care products. See what happens.
So, Rapunzel's locked away.
That's cool, I got my cell phone.
And tower with no cell phone service.
No!
Mutated early, she became immune. Actually, if you're in a comic book, there's a superheroine named Medusa who lives on the moon. She regarded all this great stuff, pushes out gravity.
Hi,
and
yeah, you do realize this is why you aren't dating anyone, right? Because you're a dork.
I spent a lot of time alone.
Just continue the story.
And for no apparent reason, the enchantress decided to use Rapunzel's hair as a liability.
Rapunzel, let down your hair to me.
Why didn't you build stairs? Or why don't you use your magical powers to fly up here?
So up come the enchantress.
Ow!
Stop that!
Ow!
What do you want?
Hey, what's my motivation here?
Doesn't really say.
Wait, so I just locked this new chick up for no reason?
Maybe you were abused as a child.
Yeah, there's really no reason for it.
Huh. I guess I'm just some type of sadistic witch.
Like an extra girlfriend.
Getting on with it. I've locked you in this tower, Rapunzel. Because a woman's place is at home. Or in the tower.
But I want a job.
You bet. Do some housework.
There's no furniture.
Make some. Goodbye. Were you going to bring me lunch?
You know what?
I forgot your sack lunch at home. I'll just have to climb back in later.
Ow! 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 Ow!
Well, just then, the prince happened to be wandering by.
Fair maiden, will you let your hair down with me?
I
stop. What's the problem?
We have nothing to talk about.
I don't have any interest.
I mean, she's a shut-in.
It's not my fault.
What are we going to talk about? Politics? I'll say something witty, and she'll say, I've been locked in a tower for 9 years. Then I'll talk about the injury at court today, and she'll say, I've been locked in a tower for 9 years.
I've been locked in a tower for 9 years.
Hey, you fall in love at first sight.
Really? I'm just going on here? That's pretty shallow.
Shouldn't we get to know each other first? I mean, I think I would think less of the prince if he fell in love with me just by looking at me. Shouldn't he get to know the inner me?
There is no inner you.
I have a very detailed journal.
Okay, this is a fairy tale, and we're trying to get through all of them. Follow at first sight, okay? Bam! Love! Not feeling the love. Bam! Love! Still nothing.
I think I felt something this time.
There was like a breeze or something?
Oh, yeah, that was it.
Jumped up.
But I'm over it. Let's see what's on the calendar for today. Turning a man into a golden goose. That should be rewarding.
So the prince walked around the aisle.
He's gonna take some getting used to. Sorry, that sounded expensive. I can pay for it, come on, prince. I'm just gonna, excuse me, ma'am, Mr.
Until coincidentally wander into a desert.
Ooh, it's getting hot in here.
Where have you ran into? You guessed it.
My prince!
And she cried out in his eyes, and that magically healed him. And they lived happily ever after, in the desert, with no hair care products or kingdoms. In the end.
But our story is not even remotely finished.
No, wait. It is finished. It's not yet begun.
That's right. So, let's get back to that girl, Rapunzel's mother. When she was younger, she went by a different name.
Greta, are you out here? What are you doing?
Oh, nothing.
You've been acting moody lately, as if something were bothering you.
It's our mother and peer pressure. You see, Hansel, she died before we were even born.
I remember.
Our next story, Hansel and Gretel, or After School Special Meets Horror Movie.
Haunted by her memory.
I too am haunted. Perhaps you ought to go into the woods where it's dark and scary.
Can I get like a cool lighting effect down here, please? Thank you. Okay, are you guys awake? Good. Because here's what we're going to do. You guys are going to be section one, and when I come to you, I want you to make a scary horror movie music sound like this. Ready? Can we try it? Section one. What horror movies have you guys been watching? Louder. Thank you. That was much better. Okay. From like the middle over, you guys don't like this one. You can just pick which side you want to be on. You guys are going to be section two, and you look a little smarter than those guys over there. I'm sorry, it's true. Look at this guy right here. He's a genius, right? He's a freaking genius. Okay, when I point to you guys, I want you to say, don't go in there. Ready? Section two.
Don't go in there!
Okay, now the rest of you guys over here, no good horror movie is complete without heavy breathing, like this. All time. Okay, ready? Section three.
really hungry. The full courts are really good. You should try one.
I'm so disappointed in today's young people. You think you can fill the half side of candy and no one's going to disturb it, but no. You two little brats come along and start munching on the walls. In my day, we didn't have to fit out of candy, and kids knew enough not to eat them. I'm going to have to teach you both a lesson. By eating you. Eating us? But not yet. I'm going to fatten you up first.
So Hansel and Gretel were locked away in force-fed sugar water like mice in one of those experiments where they grow human ears on their backs. Have you seen that picture? It's totally gross.
My back itches.
And they grew fatter and fatter, and then they died a little bit, and then they grew fatter again, until one day.
Why does my cologne smell like green?
Except you, the boy. You've got more about rugged masculinity about you.
Thank you.
Well, I need some help cleaning out my oven, and I'll take volunteers. Anyone?
Me!
Excellent! Come along, Hansel!
It's actually Hansel with an N.
Oh, right. Hansel. Could you put this in your mouth for me, please?
Sure.
Thank you. Now, you can just crawl right in here.
Section 2!
Go!
But if they're starving, then they can't put up a fight, so that's gotta be good beer, right?
I guess.
guess, you're a kidder. All right, and start your votes.
Really hasn't had a lot of luck yet.
What can alert you, Samara?
I can't see for sure, but it appears to be a worm on a hook. Yes, it is. I can confirm that now. A worm on a hook.
She's going the traditional route.
Absolutely. It doesn't appear to be helping her, though, because she hasn't caught Jack. Nothing. Not a zip. She's trying to give the enzymes in her stomach to borrow muscle tissue. She slowly starves to death. This will not be pretty. Let's watch. Nothing. No bites. Nothing. Do you mind? Cracks are beginning to show.
Let's see how the other competitors are doing.
Shocking developments, Cameron. All the other competitors have starved to death.
Wait a minute.
It's you! I'm going to eat for a month!
Okay, fine. You caught me.
Welcome to the show, Talking Fish. Thank you, it's
nice to be here, breathing air. And this is your life.
Oh, really?
Well, if we get it right, here's the rules. We'll grab three people from your past who may or may not have turned you into a talking fish. Two will be lies, and one is the truth. And we'll be grabbing one lucky person from the audience to decide. How about you? It's okay, I'm gonna hurt you. Okay. Give it up for Colin, everybody.
Thank you. Kiss me. It's because I'm ugly, right? That's why you won't kiss me? Hey, look over there!
And the princess was very concerned, so she talked to her father, the king.
So, I have this friend, and she agreed to be friends with the talking frog because he had a role. But now the frog is pressuring her to kiss him. What should she do?
There's a talking frog.
Maybe.
Honey, aren't you the talking frog?
I'm a friend! I probably shouldn't have told you that.
All right, look, you made a deal with this frog, didn't you? So you gave your word, so I guess you know what you need to do now.
But I think of it more as a friend than a boyfriend.
Honey, let me tell you a story about your father when he was your age. See, I was something of a boy.
Daddy.
I was. I played Dungeons and Dragons, clothes. And there was this girl who I was friends with. She was beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. And we would walk home from school every day, and she'd tell me all the problems she was having with whatever problem she was dating at the time. And I'd listen to her every day. And she would always say, "Why can't they be nice like you?" I was in love with that girl, and I just kept waiting for my chance. Until one day, after she'd been dumped by a latest jerk, and she came to my house after a party, and it was raining outside, and she gave me this huge hug. So I thought that's my chance, so I leaned in to kiss her.
And that's why you thought we got together?
And she said, "What are you doing? I don't want to ruin our friendship." It was as if my heart had been plucked out of my chest and popped like a grape. And she looked down at the oozing juice of my soul and said, I don't think so. It was as if my mother had been dismembered with a meat cleaver, and she used the blood spatter wreckage of my life as a cage liner for a pet cockatiel from Moe to poop on. Is it
okay? Get it!
Well, after I became king, girls started to like me. You'll figure. But what I'm telling you is this. Get back in there and kiss that damn frog. Kiss him for all the losers and dorks out there who haven't been kissed by their princesses. Kiss him for that guy in the audience who thinks he's on a date, but really isn't, because she doesn't really like him like that. Kiss him for that guy in the audience who came here thinking he was going to meet all the chicks but found out that every single one of them had to take by some jerk. Kiss him for the sad, the weird, the skinny, the not all athletic, and the guys with a pudgy body are props you should probably show them. Kiss him there, bro!
This is for you, Daddy.
This is your daddy.
A dwarf.
I prefer a little person.
In fact, two dwarfs.
What are you, seven? I prefer dwarves.
The peace dwarves work all day in the mines.
I can work it on the railroad.
Mines?
We're so wild, you work.
We can't use that song.
I do whatever.
Anyway. to wear the dwarf. Big deal. She'll grow to love me.
And with that...
Okay, I'm not actually comfortable with the kissing part.
Oh, come on. You're fine. Maybe I'll put a woman in a coma.
It's like a lifetime movie.
Sorry, that was me. The beef is tearing on my insides.
Can we get back to the story, please? You are ruining my magic.
Hi.
And it was love at first sight.
Oh! You're a dwarf!
Little person.
Yes, I'm the mighty dwarf Slappy, and I've come to rescue you from the curse of
the world. I wasn't under a curse, I was just tired.
I'm your one true love. I don't know the lyrics.
It's okay, I wrote it down for you. I've been working on this for a while now.
There once was a girl who fell in love with a man about 4'2".
Respond to rhyme English.
Why is it so difficult?
Mirror, mirror hanging over there. How do I make the young people care?
Put it in a music video with hot chicks.
Stupid.
And just then,
caretaker. pity you. Anyway, this is a very special story. It's occupied a Hallmark channel.
Can I get some kind of soft, warm, fuzzy light, please? Some kind of soft, warm glow around everyone's seat. Could you try that again, please?
To me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you. This is a very special moment right now, and you're really ruining that special moment.
You crab person,
fight me!
What did you say to me? This is a family show, you walking poppy tressings. You don't know what your tressings means, do you? Where'd you get that picture of my mom?
Come on here and find out!
You're dead!
Blah, blah, blah,
fine, but now I have to fit that into her storyline.
Well, that's okay, because before she was the devil's grandmother, she was a little girl.
That's deep.
Anyway, once upon a time, Little Red Cap. I thought it was supposed to be Little Red Riding Hood. Okay, first of all, you're not a hood just because you wear red. Not everyone who wears red is in a gang. And second of all, we're going by what's written, so you're Little Red Cap.
Fine, jerk. I didn't say anything.
Anyway, Little Red Cap, while I'm off to my grandmother's house to give her these sweets I made, you see, Little Red's grandmother was kind of a fat loser.
Little Red, where are you with grandmother's sweets? Grandmother needs her sweets, or else she'll starve to death, and it'll be all your fault. You wouldn't want that now, would you? I'm dying!
Boy, Grandma really knows how to turn on the guilt. I guess I'll have to go into these dark and scary woods alone. Although, that doesn't seem like a very good idea. The woods? Alone? You know what that means. Section one! I'm frightened. And section three. Oh, louder! What's going on? And section one, come on! I just need to stop. Come on, section three, you're snapping. If only I could see what's going on. And stop! Wait!
Look!
Make one move and I'll blow your furthest brains out!
Help! Okay, no, wait, hold on.
What is it?
This is a children's story. You can't have a little red being a gun-toting psychopath.
I don't see any problem with it. That's really odd.
This is a children's story?
Right, a children's story about a giant mutant wolf who devours a little old lady, lays in wait for her granddaughter before eating her too, and then being chopped open by a homeless man. Right, a children's story with a nice moral.
What's the moral?
Never go outside, ever.
Okay, fine, but there's no gun in the ritual. We can't have a gun on stage.
You're infringing on my Second Amendment rights. I have the right to protect myself against predatory animals. Okay, be quiet. What do you want to do then?
I say we do this like an actual children's story. Instead of a nightmare you've seen slasher movie.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't want to be a wolf if I don't get to eat anybody.
Can I still have my gun? I don't feel safe without it.
No. No. And no! Off stage!
After the show is over, I'm going to meet you in the alley, and there's going to be a reckoning.
So, once upon a time, there was a little girl named Little Red Cap.
Boy, am I in the dumps. It's kind of a rainy day. I get sad on rainy days.
Well, hiya, Little Red!
Hi!
Can I let you in on a secret? Sometimes I get sad on little days, too.
Oh, really? A big wolf like you?
That's right. But you know what I do? I sing a song!
May I sing along?
Sure can! Oh, the rain may come a-falling down, and the birds crawl from the ground, but a frown turns upside down when a rainbow comes around.
When a rainbow comes around. When a rainbow comes around.
Oh, the rain may make you sneeze, sit in your old coffin weeds. But if you'll just wait 1 second, please, for a rainbow through the trees.
For a rainbow through the trees.
For a rainbow through the trees.
Grandma, Granny Woodcutter, that sure was a wonderful song, Wolfie. Let's all hop. You know, Grandma, elderly people have so much wisdom to share with the rest of us.
They sure do.
Well, I do have one piece of wisdom. Share it, share it.
Sharing is radical.
What was that?
That was my air guitar.
May I see it? Now remember what we said about sharing, Grandma Woodcutter.
Okay.
Well, I've learned a valuable lesson today about rainbows and sharing. I'm going to go off and become a vegetarian and learn more about the environment, because that's what a good citizen does.
Bye, Wolfie.
Bye-bye.
happily ever after. And we shared and appreciated rainbows.
And little red Lego married that woodcutter and had a daughter.
Who married a demon.
I do not like that demon.
She's going through a rebellion stages.
And after he left, chasing after a one-legged dancing girl, their daughter gave birth to a son, the devil. And that's how she became the devil's grandmother.
That child is the devil.
Hush your mouth. And little red lived a long, long life until she got the Alzheimer's.
That was a shame.
Yeah.
So, to recap, once upon a time there was a little girl from the hood who was Nevi Wolf, married a woodcutter, and had a daughter married a demon who they gave birth to the devil, because her daughter was coming in for
little person!
Met up with another dwarf.
Little person!
Who rescued a girl from a witch who married a prince and had a son who was that same witch to becoming a frog who was friends with a talking fish. Who was caught by a future girl, later turned into another witch who was killed training two little children, one of whom grew up to marry a prince and made a series of unfortunate deals with the true supernatural beings, who had another daughter, Rapunzel, who was taken away by an enchantress locked away in a high tower until she was rescued by another prince. And there were no gravity.
That's all about right.
Yeah, but I gotta say, haven't we done all of them that are in this book?
Not the important ones. Excuse me?
What?
Aren't you forgetting someone, or, I don't know, some story? No, don't think so.
Yeah, we got all the famous ones. There's a whole bunch about talking foxes, but who cares about those?
I hate foxes.
And some other talking animals, and some giants, and a whole bunch of random peasants shooting dead on things, but...
Yeah. Once upon a time, thank you!
There was a little orphan girl.
Oh, I am orphaned! I am sad!
Can we pause here for just a second?
Oh, life! So sad!
What is it?
there was some really bad beef in the catering.
Oh, the catering is bad!
I had beef.
Yeah, so everyone's throwing up back there.
Excuse me.
And I'm pretty sure we don't have enough actors left to do this one.
Well, I guess we can skip it then.
No! We are not skipping it!
How many actors do we have left?
You listen here, you little reject from Nickelodeon! We are going to do this scene! You are going to make me look good and I am going to get a full feature film of it! You got it?
Okay.
So got it? Or I will take your tiny beating heart and feed to my actual pestering man! Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Whoa. Thank you.
Cinderella, I need you to get me ready for the ball.
What ball?
then, Cinderella's wicked stepmother entered.
Cinderella, what seems to be the problem?
Life! Life and the misery it entails! If only my mother, my whore! Dead mother, forgive! She will take me to the ball!
Well, why don't you come and sit on your stepmother's lap?
That's weird.
Get over it.
You have
Sir, there is. Put on the dress, Odessa.
So, Cinderella had her dress, and she felt very pretty.
I feel very pretty. Thank you, birds. Tweet, tweet. Now I shall walk to the ball.
But the ball was guarded by a bouncer, a one-armed, eye-patch-wing Scottish pirate named Matt.
Or what she be doing in this here ball? If it ain't Scottish, it's crap! I'd like something to come in, please. Shut it!
And just then, Cinderella's wicked stepmother and two wicked stepsisters entered.
Cinderella? What are you doing here? You suck!
And then the swarm of birds came down, pecked at Max on the ride.
Tweet, tweet, tweet. Peck, peck, peck. Oh, the eye! Sweet, I'm in.
And it was a wonderful ball, a huge ball, and everyone danced. Unfortunately, the wicked stepmother only knew how to do the cha-cha. One wicked stepsister was doing the waltz, and the other one only knew how to do the whip. They did manage to have a conversation, though. And went like this.
You should go dance with the prince. He's so dreamy. I'm going with books.
A little of that, the prince shows up looking for a girl who fits the shoe.
all over your foot. Oh, then I popped a pimple in the bathroom. No, you didn't. You cut off your toes. I've never had toes. Cabbage. Okay.
So she went home. The prince returned to the house to find the other wicked stepsister.
You're sick!
Let's go to
You're dead!
romantic favors.
That's it.
Kiss him!
Goodbye, Rumble.